following, I will give you a short introduction to the topic that is given to me. And then I will give you a background of Jewish way of teaching and Jewish way of studying scripture. And then we will deal with an example or examples. And then we will have illustrations of Jesus' use of critical thinking in teaching. That will be your workshop. And then we go to lesson planning and catechetical programs if there is still time. But I think the previous speakers have already been giving you clues and guidelines with regards to programs and lesson planning. I saw that in the presentation of Dr. Domingo in relation to leadership, marami na siyang ano, binigay na guidelines para sa inyo. Yesterday, with Father Bert, you were also given several clues already. In fact, he tried to give everything that is supposed to be embodied in the previous speakers. Thank you. The previous speaker's content, no? Alright, so we will try to do as much as we can. If there is no time, then we will continue sa Friday or Saturday as the case may be. Right. So, this is a course I was informed, although we did not have a meeting together with other professors, it's very mysterious, or rather, it is providential that we know where we are heading to. This is supposed to be a training of trainers. Kaya mga bata dito, maging trainer na kayo sa mga kabataan din, ha? Training of trainers for a certificate. And this certificate is in catechetical leadership and supervision. Kaya, bukas ba? Oo, bukas magkakaroon din tayo ng training on how to handle money. Or, you know, because that is also part of the catechetical program. We cannot continue our work without money. Although money is not the most important, it is a tool in being able to actualize the dreams that we have. The dreams that you have identified before. So, in the course description, we said critical thinking has been regarded as an essential tool in the educational process today. In the area of evangelization and catechesis, critical thinking is considered an important methodology wherein different types of questioning stimulate conversations about the content of the faith and the manner it is being passed on to others. If those of you who are a little bit younger than I am, I think I'm the oldest here, know that when we were in grade 1, grade 2, in the elementary grades, we were just asked to memorize, why are we created by God? To know Him, to serve Him, and to love Him forever in heaven. Wala nang ibang sagot. Mag-question ka, you're suspended, natividad. Always asking questions. Yung mga ganun ba? So, we did not learn how to ask questions about the things that we are supposed to believe. But now, since it is the age of post-truth, post-modernism, ang dami-daming lumalabas ng questions. And in my experience with those who get out of the church, I see that there are so many things they don't understand. That is why they get out. They ask the teacher gets angry because the teacher does not know the answer. And you ask the priest has no time. That's understandable because the priests are busy with so many things. No? Sacramentally. At yun nga, hindi naintindihan ng mga born again. Ano mga sacraments na yan? Where in the Bible do you find confirmation? Tatanungin sa isang estudyante ng Lasal. Sasabihin, basta ikaw, iba. Kami, iba. Oh, you go on with your belief, I go on with my belief also. Where in the Bible does it say this? Rosary, it says there in Matthew 5, don't repeat and repeat your prayers. Why are you repeating your prayers? Why are you repeating the Hail Mary? And where did that Hail Mary come from? We cannot say it is the infancy narratives, ano? And then the other part comes from the church. But there is nothing, there's nothing wrong with that, but we don't know how to deal with that. Questions. That is why some of our brothers and sisters came up with the ano yung mga fighters for the faith?
Defenders.
Yes, and I learned that the faith defenders trained themselves so well that they stood in the platform of Cagayan de Oro Bayon and challenged the Iglesia ni Cristo. Anybody would like to come to ask questions to us, you can come. And I learned from the radio station that they won, no? The Catholics. But on further reflection, sabi nga ni Father kahapon, experiences should be reflected on. Nasasayang kasi ang experiences pag hindi mo yan i-reflect. Sayang yung mga experiences na dumadaan lang sa buhay natin na hindi natin i-reflect. No? So, upon reflection, sabi ko, isinulat pa ang Biblia para pag-awayan? Isinulat pa ang Biblia para pag-debatehan? Okay? So, my studies showed to me that it is not for debate. It is not for quarreling. Nandun nga sa John 17, diba? That all may be one. Sana tayo magkaisa. And we can always disagree in an agreeable manner. Hindi yung nagkakaaway-away tayo. But we see also in the history of the church na ano kasi yan eh, it is given. Sabi nga ni Father, may mga preferential options. Yung preferential option for the poor sa amin sa St. Mary's kanin, kasi yung aming presidente eh, may apat na angels. No? So sabi namin, preferential option for the four. May mga taong nasa paligid, I mean, sa gilidgers, yung tawag natin kapon, di ba?
Sa mga gilid lamang.
The history of the church, na anong tayo dyan, na sanay tayo na magkakaiba, di ba? Although we speak about unity, in reality, there is no unity. Why? Because there is discrimination. Why? Because of the thinking pattern. For me, from the very beginning, you cannot change anybody unless he changes his ways of thinking. If you don't change your way of thinking, you will not be able to change as a person. You cannot change anything if you do not change your way of thinking. Father mentioned that I come from Ifugao. I'm from Kiangan. And when I was in high school, grabe yung aming kompetensya with one another, Kiangan, Lagawi, Badawi, Mayawiaw, and Kiangan always feel superior. So I grew up in that idea that Kiangan is the best, always the best. When I got out of Kiangan and went out to Baguio, you cannot always be the best everywhere. You have to be humble and say, well, you cannot be, there are other things, there are other people who have more knowledge and their eyes are more open than you. But the moment you close your eyes, the moment you close your mind to other things, you will not be able to change. That is what is meant by paradigm shift. Baguhin ang pananaw, baguhin ang pagtingin sa tao, pagtingin sa sarili. I was born also with that. So I grew up with that inferiority complex. That's why I became a fighter. Because of that, when I studied in Baguio during my elementary grades, they said, Igorota, Igorota. Diferensya sa Igorota, so I look at my face, yung buho ko ganyan, kasi grido pa lang ako nun. Oo nga, bakit kasi ganyan ang buho ko? No? So, and then, they learned that our way of, drumming the gong is, there is a way of drumming the gong which is called pagadut. So they say, pagadut mo. So, when I enter the classroom, pagadut, pagadut. It's very angry. Bakit sinabi ni Father yung kanyang background kahapon? Ito ang kanyang pinag-aralan, dito siya nanggaling, etc. Because it is all in our unconscious. The unconscious is not something that we do not know. The unconscious is the storage. It is in our brain, the storage of everything that has happened in our lives. And at a certain point in our lives, natri-trigger yan yung mga karanasan nating noong karaan. So every time they say, Gorota, nagagalit ako, bakit? Ano bang diferensya ng Gorota sa mga Ilocano na yan? Sabi ko, and then I research, ano ba yung mga, bakit mga Ilocano ganyan? Bakit yung mga Islanders ganyan? Ay, nako, sabi ko, hindi kami, we were not subdued by the Spaniards. Kayo, yung nakiisa sa mga Spaniards. Ayan, dumi-dumi ninyo, sabi nila. Kasi kami, nagtatrabaho kami sa bundok. Kayo, nakaupo lang dyan. Ang linis-linis ng kaldero nyo, wala naman pala kayong iluluto. I learned to be a fighter because of the bullying. And then, my question while I was in the mountains was,
how come they say they are Christians? Kristiyano daw sila. Pero bakit ganun? Pag pumupunta kami sa bayan, bakit? Hindi ba kami tao? Hindi daw, kasi galing daw kami sa unggoy.
Yung ganun ba? But of course, those things are belong to the past. When Christianity came in and when the missionaries came in, doon kami nabilib eh. Kasi yung mga galing sa ibang bansa, hindi naman Pilipino, galing sa ibang bansa, mga Belgians at saka mga taga-Holland. Kumakain, kinakain nila. Alam nyo ba kung paano namin iluluto yung manok noon? Paano ba yung father? Di ba? Alisin mo yung feathers. Ganun mo lang sa fire. Tapos alisin mo talaga. And then chop it into two and then plop. Then 1, 2, 3. Kakainin na. So what?
Susunugin naman.
Susunugin. Oo nga, susunugin. Pero yung mga taga-Manilang pupunta doon sa bundok, dumating yung mga missionaries, nakita namin, nakikain sila sa amin, nagdala sila ng mga corned beef, cornmeal, at saka, ako nagtatanong, sino mga ito? Galing sa ibang bansa, ang gwapo nila, ang gaganda ng mga madre, pero bakit sila pumunta dito? And then that arose my missionary spirit, kasi sabi ko, wow, if they can sacrifice for other countries, why can we not sacrifice for our own people? No, so yun nga, kailangang mag-isip. But then of course in school, you have to obey. Hasod the desk, natividad. Yes, father. Maya-maya, pahiram na yung layer mo kasi ako'y gumagawa ng rosaries noon. For my tuition fee, 10 centavos per rosary. That was of course in the 60s. You were not yet born, Erica. You were still in the dream or in the love letters of God. Kaya maganda itong kwento ko kasi it belongs to the past, but it is relived in the present. Kasi yung nakaraan natin, may sinasabi tungkol sa kasalukuyan. Our past is, we are what we are now because of our past. And we will be what we will be in the present, in the future because of our present. That is why it's very important to decide and to think what to do now. Because what we do now will have implications of what will happen in the future. Kaya ako, I will not be here to see all those destructions siguro dito sa ating bansa. But I am worried with the way things are going, no? With the mountains and with the rivers that we hold so dear. Because for us in the mountains, natural resources is one with us. It is one with us. When you cut a tree, it's very, very painful to the heart, especially when that tree has been how many years old since the time of your ancestors, and then you just cut the tree like that. Parang masakit. But anyway, what we're talking about here is critical thinking is considered an important methodology. And critical thinking has to be stimulated by the teacher. If it is not stimulated by the teacher, have the nerve to ask questions as a student, because it is in asking questions that you search for answers. And that is why I became interested with the Bible, because my major is Filipino. Why Filipino? Kasi hindi kami marunong mag-Tagalog sa sa bundok. So sabi ko, bakit lahat ng ating Filipino teacher dito ay important? Ako, unang maging Filipino teacher dito. So nag-major ako ng Tagalog. Major ako Filipino. Pagbalik ko doon, mag-apply ako, sabi ng principal, sorry natin kasi dalawa kayong aplikante eh. Yung isa, may asawa. Walang trabaho yung asawa. Kaya siya nalakunin namin. Ikaw naman, dalaga ka. Pwede kang magliwaliw kahit saan. Sinabi yung gano'n, sige, liwaliw ako. Hindi na ako babalik dito. Kaya hindi na ako bumalik talaga. Kasi profession demanded that I had to go from one place to the other. But kidding aside, no? You have to initiate questions with yourself para the more you ask questions, the more search you have, because in the Bible, not everything is given in the Bible. You have to ask questions to be able to look for the answers. And sometimes when you see the answers ahead of the others, you have to be the one to go outside the box. That's why it's very, very difficult to be a head. It's very, very difficult to be a supervisor. You have to be humble. Because suppose one of your members see something better than you do, sometimes our way of thinking will say, very humiliating naman na siya ang nakakita, bakit hindi ako? And you don't have everything eh. As simple as that. But our ego will tell us, ah, kailangan ikaw, kasi ikaw yung ano, ikaw yung head, ikaw yung pare, ikaw yung madre. Alright? So, but nowadays, with the advent of so many things that are happening, and with the thirst of people to understand more, we have to encourage critical thinking. And we have to encourage critical thinking together, not only one. So, but yesterday, Father mentioned this. What is involved in thinking? Does critical thinking as a methodology involve? It involves conceptualizing, yung sinabi kong dream, and then analyze, then apply, synthesize, evaluate information. Or you can just use what Father gave you yesterday, there. No, you have the data. Gather the data. What is the data? Why is the data like that? And then analyze the data. And after analyzing the data, what do you do? Reflect. Reflection is very, very important. And that is also the pattern that I saw yesterday. It's also present in Lectio Divina. Because what do we do in Lectio Divina? Lectio. That is the data already, especially when you have the Bible. By the way, we need the Bible. So the data is there. But what do you do with the data? Analyze the data. Sometimes we take the data from the Bible at face value, hindi po. Kasi ang Biblia ay sinulat as literature. And you know that literature has different genre. Meron kang parables, meron kang miracle stories, meron kang narration, meron kang myths, no? And just to insert it, that is why I don't advise yung grade 1 na you teach creation. Kasi yung creation naman is a myth, no? But you don't go to grade 1 to tell them it is a myth. You have to analyze that. It was written during the time of Solomon. So find some other ways to come up with a more realistic and more touching. It has to touch the heart. Touching ways of touching topics to according to the level. So those of you who are with me in religious education, you know that different kinds of learning has to be adapted to the different levels of the students or of the child. So, ito, synthesizing, evaluating information gathered from or generated by observation, experience, reflection, reasoning, or communication as a guide to belief and action. Natutuwa ako kasi nagparadigm shift talaga si Father Guzman. Diba? Lagi naming diskusyon ng dalawa yung kami tatlo, ni na Father Rose. Ano ba naman yung doctrine moral worship ninyo na yan? Sabi ko, naghihingalo na yung mga katikista sa kaano, sa kaanalis. Ano ba yung doctrine? Saan magaling yung doctrine? Diba sa Biblia? Father, Biblia na lang. Hindi, but they have to know to catechize and they have to know yung mga daw, yung tatlong elements na yan. Doctrine, moral, worship. At ang mga katikista, hirap na hirap talaga sa paggawa ng lesson plan noon. Dinutugo na sila sa ato sa paggawa ng lesson plan. So sabi ko, is there no other way to make a lesson plan aside from that na ano, hihiwalayin mo yung doctrine, moral, worship? Kahit naman sa explanation mo, Father, pwede mo namang ano eh, i-integrate yung tatlo without saying this is doctrine, this is moral, this is worship. Kasi hindi naman yan magkakahiwalay, dapat magkaisa yan. Kaya diba sabi niya sa inyo eh, Father, ikaw naman nagturo sa amin ng doctrine, moral, worship. Tapos sabi niya, eh nagbago naman ako, ano? Kasi nga, yung shift sa ano, sa Bible. Why? Because in 2008, the Pope of our Pope Benedict called a meeting of all the bishops around the world to find out why there is an exodus of Catholics to the Pentecostals. The biggest wave daw is the Pentecostals. So Bishop Ambo told me there are two things daw. First, na cause is because of their fellowship. Maliliit kasi yung mga grupo na yan. So they're very happy when they see each other. Sa atin, meron din tayong peace be with you, pero panandalian lang. Umisa nga sa mga teenagers dito, pero lang sila. Pagano, nung nagtuturo ako dito, no? So, ano, I comment on that. And then, the second one is because of their knowledge of the Bible, kuno. The knowledge of the Bible, they can quote anything from the Bible. Actually, when I got sick and I was hospitalized, when the Catholics come to visit me, ay, nati, ikaw kasi, ang tigas ang ulo mo, dapat itong kainin mo, o itong kainin mo, ha? Tapos pupunuhin nila yung refrigerator ng hospital. Tapos awalan kami, and then, oh, sige, alis na kami, ha? Alis na sila. Tapos pupunta yung mga, ano, yung mga galing sa Philippine Bible Society, mga Methodistian, mga born again, mga Christian, naman. Ang una-unang gagawin, sasabihin sa akin, nati, ano na naman ang nangyari? Sige, pray over ka namin. Nasaan yung paa mo? Itong paa ko. So, sige. Kasi na, ano ako, ng Staphylococcus aureus. So, sige, nasaan yung paa mo? Ipagandasan natin. Talaga naman, from the bottom of their hearts, hindi sila, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord, our Father. Hindi ganyan. Hindi yung mga memorized prayers galing sa kaibuturan ng kanilang puso. Andito na naman po ang aming kapatid na si Nati. Naghihingalo na siya. Kaya ipagdasal namin, Panginoon. Isa sila talaga. Very touching. Ikaw naman na may sakit. Meron ako mga, kung meron silang mga libro, meron din ako mga libro dito. No? Ikaw naman na may sakit. Siyempre, you go with the ano? You go with the thinking, the prayer. Ang sinasabi dito, when is your mind at its best? When you are peaceful and when you believe what you are saying. Diba? And then ito, rethink how you think. Everything is in the mind. All in the mind. Pag iniisip mong, may sakit ako, sige, may sakit na talaga. Pero kung sabihin mo, kaya ko to. That is tested and proven in my experience. Ewan ko sa experience mo. Kasi nga, September 17 noon, last day ko sa hospital, September 18, meron akong seminar doon sa Davao. Sabi, Doc, kailangan akong alis ngayon. Bakit? May seminar ako sa Davao. Ay, hindi pwede. Ay, hindi. Magpahinga na lang po ako sa bahay. Ay, naku, paglabas ko, 7 o'clock in the evening, sabi ko sa kapatid ko, straight to the airport. Kapatid ko, huwag ka nang paangal-angal dyan. Straight to the airport. Sabi ko sa sarili ko, Lord, kaya ko ito. Kasi sabi ko kasi patayin mo na ako eh. Hindi mo naman ako pinapatay. Kasi sa sakit talaga, sabi ko, Lord, punin mo na ako. I am stronger with psychological pain. But with physical pain, nakikita ko pa lang yung needle na igaganyan. Bakit mo, why do you do that intentionally to hurt me? Parang ganun ang ko. Ang nasa isip ko, so, kain ako. Anyway, so, what I'm just telling you is the mind helps us a lot in our ministry. What you put in your mind, you become. What you think, you become. Unless we change our paradigms, we cannot affect what we're talking about from day one until today. We have to change our ways of thinking. In this course, catechetical leaders will be accompanied to reflect on the biblical passages that illustrate Jesus' use of critical thinking in lesson planning and in developing various catechetical programs. Learning to think and to live biblically. Sana magkaroon na tayo ng paradigm shift para matuto tayo. How do we think and live biblically? Sinabi ng lahat ng speakers ito. Pero unless we change our mindset, unless we have paradigm shift, hindi ito mangyayari, sabi ko sa inyo. So si Father kanina sabi niya, ma'am, sa simbahan pa naman, ay sa tablet, sabi niya, yung dream ko po, sabi niya, ito yung dream ko, ganito na ang gagawin ko kasi yan ang dream ko. Saan ba nanggagaling yan? sa isip mo, bakit marami kang nakita? Meaning to say, meron mga observation, may mga experiences ka, na-process mo yung experience na yan, na-analyze mo, kaya ito ang gagawin mo. So the implementation is based from your mindset, from what you think and what you commit yourself dearly to. So our areas of concern here will be biblical passages that illustrate Jesus' use of critical thinking. And then, syempre, lesson planning sa inyo na yan. Kasi kayo ang nagplaplano, hindi ako. Some people like ready-made lesson plans. You can have ready-made lesson plans, but the implementation will be different. It is different when you yourself are guided. Sabi dito, guide lang ako, ha? Hindi ako gagawa ng lesson plan nyo. Guide to lesson planning and developing various catechetical programs. But I think the catechetical programs are already with you, no? You just have to look at it and improve it or develop it. Because the guidelines have been given by Dr. Domingo and Father Bert, and the content has been given by Bishop Pabilio, Father Barot, also Father Leander. Okay, so while you're copying, we are going to give all of this in a bulk. So I waited until this will be finished so we can give it to you in a bulk. Right? Anyway, I'm just asking a question. So, this is the course that is given to me to do is